Yes, it is.
That's the most crucial and important thing in our life, because it all begins with God. I don't know how some people can think that it's just one of the issues. It's the key issue. They don't have any better issue, because without life, you have nothing.
Amen.
Craig, you got a few words to say?
Just out here standing on the side of truth. As Camille just said, without life there's nothing else. So this is the first and foremost of all things that we must stand for.
All right. Thank you, gents and ladies.
which you extend to all creation, especially to us, made in your image and likeness. Father, extend your hand of protection to those threatened by abortion and save them from its destructive power. Give your strength to all, Father, that they may never give in to the fear that may tempt them to facilitate abortion. Bless our families and bless our land, that we may have the joy of welcoming and nurturing the life of which you are the source and the eternal Father.
Amen. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Please respond, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy upon us. God the Father, creator of the world,
have mercy on us.
God the Son, through whom all things were made,
have mercy on us.
God the Holy Spirit, Lord and giver of life,
have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, the beginning and the end,
have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life,
have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, the resurrection and the life,
have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, eternal word of life,
have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, living in the womb of the Blessed Virgin,
have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, lover of the poor and the weak,
have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, defender of the helpless,
have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, bread of life,
have mercy on us.
For every sin against life,
have mercy on us.
For the sin of abortion,
have mercy on us.
For the daily killing of innocent babies,
have mercy on us.
For the blood shed throughout our land,
have mercy on us.
For the silent screams of your children,
have mercy on us.
For the killing of your future disciples,
have mercy on us.
For the exploitation of women by abortion,
have mercy on us.
For the silence of your people,
have mercy on us.
For the apathy of your people,
have mercy on us.
For the cooperation of your people in this tragedy,
have mercy on us.
For our preborn brothers and sisters killed by abortion,
have mercy on us.
For our preborn brothers and sisters threatened by abortion,
have mercy on us.
For our brothers and sisters who have survived abortion,
have mercy on us.
For our mothers who have had abortion,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers attempted to have abortion,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers pressured to have abortion,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers who have refused to have abortion,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For fathers of aborted babies,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the families of aborted babies,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the families of those tempted to have abortion,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For abortionists,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who assist and cooperate in abortions,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For doctors and nurses, that they may nurture life,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, that they may defend life,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the clergy, that we may speak up for life,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the pro-life movement,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who speak rights and work to end abortion,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who help provide alternatives to abortion,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who promote adoption,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For national and local pro-life groups,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For unity in the pro-life movement,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For courage and perseverance in pro-life work,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer ridicule and rejection, for their stand for life,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those imprisoned for defending life,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have been injured and mistreated for defending life,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For legal professionals,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For courts and judges,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For police officers,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For educators,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For media professionals,
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for the babies saved from abortion,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For thanksgiving for the mothers saved and healed from abortion.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Thanksgiving for the former abortion providers who have become pro-life.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And thanksgiving for those who take a stand against abortion.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Thanksgiving for the call to be part of the pro-life movement.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-living God, you have created all things through your Son, Jesus Christ. He trampled the power of death by his paschal mystery. May all who acknowledge his acknowledge you promote the sacredness of life and always serve you faithfully through the same Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The God who made the world and all that is in it, the Lord of heaven and earth, does not dwell in sanctuaries but by human hands. Nor is he served by human hands because he needs anything. Rather, it is he who gives to everyone life and breath and everything. He made from one the whole human race to dwell on the entire surface of the earth. And he fixed and ordered the seasons and the boundaries of their region so that people might seek God, even perhaps grope for him and find him, though indeed he is not far away from any one of us. God may protect all unborn babies and keep them safe from the scourge of abortion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all women who have had abortions and for those who feel tempted and afraid, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may bless all doctors and nurses and help them use their skills to heal and foster life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all elected officials, that they courageously advance the cause of life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who work in the pro-life movement, that they move forward with haste to the great day of victory, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God strengthens all pro-lifers who suffer ridicule, rejection, or imprisonment, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, that they may share the full glory of heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We praise you, O God, Lord and giver of life. We look to you in the sure hope that you will grant these prayers through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit,
Creator of all things, you who breathed over the waters at the dawn of creation and brought forth all living things, you who filled the apostles with the risen Lord and glory for the first of Easter night, giving them the power to restore life to those dead in sin, you who on the last day will breathe again over all the dead and raise them from the grave.
Come,
we in our world again.
Could we have your attention? Talk louder.
Stand up there.
All those who are here for the first time,
would you
please raise your hand? You've been here for the first time, so I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's somebody else here. Okay, well, I just want to thank you for coming in, and I hope that you'll be back next year after this is an ongoing effort, okay? You don't want to give up on this, okay? And of course, those who have returned over here are so dedicated that really my heart goes out to you in gratitude for being here once again. I also like to share a little prayer that I found. It's a personal prayer. It's written in first person. Father doesn't mind. I'd like to recite it. And make this prayer your own personal prayer. Okay, this time. You just had a community prayer. But this is for your own personal view. Okay? It says, Dear Lord, may I remember that your holy presence always shines within and around me. And my health, or that of a loved one, fluctuates in body, mind, and soul. Help me focus more on your power and my blessings. The charm of God to be at peace, and all shall be right. Even if I doubt or fear, with God, all things are possible. We are connected to you, the source of healing and life. And should my prayers not turn out exactly as I wish, may I rejoice that you're still with me, lighting up the path, encouraging joy and blessing all that you're about. In you, there is always hope. Two things I want to mention, okay? I don't know if any of you have heard of Vanity Sites
for pro-life.
Pro-life plates.